Hey guys, DD Amy here. So we're gonna do some basing some drifting here on Tunguska. We're gonna start off over here, and we're gonna be using the wacky rig setup here. That's what we're using right here. I'm using just using a 15 kg leader. Don't think it really matters. Using medium 6 hooks, we're using a 2.5 size lures here. So this is a nasty worm, 2.5009, and we're just gonna go ahead cast, get this out there. Gonna lower that drag down a little bit. On this side, using something similar, 2.505. This is the white W stick. I think I need to cast that one a little further. That one's fine. Then the one in the center. Oh, I already got a fish on. Okay. Okay. Get that a little further. Okay, make sure to check this one. Okay, nothing on it. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and cast this one. This one a little bit different. This one the same hook. This one is a nasty worm, 2.5002. Actually, I want to make sure the speed is actually official. Say make sure the speed is actually high as it goes on this one. And you might get some luck with the broad whitefish. So I got a fish on. Well, if you guys want to get peelage and broad whitefish, just throw these the wacky rig out. As I'm trying to say is I want to make sure I keep this at the full speed. That way I can pull it out right away if I have to. This fish is tiny. Asian smelt. We got a fish on that one, and a fish on this one. Maybe another broad white fish. Ooh, a humpback. Nice. Nothing on that one. So this is the real way how the wacky rig works. I know I posted a video yesterday about the wacky rig, but this is how it actually works. You basically just drift. You see how it says drift with the current? That's what you want. You got a fish on that one, and maybe a fish on that one too. You might get a trophy doing this. And up the friction brake just a little bit. Okay, so what we're gonna be doing, we're just gonna be drifting to about right through here, and he's gonna turn around and go back through this. This is where you're gonna find your these fish. Got a fish on both poles here. Yeah, perch pull and drag. That could be mean that these reels might be a bit damaged. I don't know, last time I fished these. Didn't take long for a bite on that. Starting to get perched now. Okay, so what we're gonna do, seeing that we're catching small fish right now and perch, we're just gonna back up. I'm not gonna actually no, I'm just gonna just go right back there. Ah, takes too long to back up. I'm too lazy for that. Okay, that's good. Dang, that didn't take long. We got a good fish on that one. Oh, never mind. I thought it was a good fish, and then it was just an archer. Not much to go after. Oh, the bite rate was good, then it just slowed down. Maybe something to do with the temperature? I don't know. This one might be one. Yep. It's a small fish. This one's not that small. This one might be a char though. Oh, that's not a char, that's a nice broad whitefish. Weird, I thought it felt like it, didn't it? I think you can drift like this throughout the night too. Maybe you might actually find some Omars. If not on the wacky rig, you can just change to just a jigging rig. Here back to the area where the perch are in. This little area right here, the 16, is where we're finding them broad whitefish and stuff. But maybe we might be able to find them in the 17. And 15 range. I don't think we can't go that far though. Those ain't perch. Oh, maybe it is. It's kind of had a good bend to it though. Arbitrary. Something on that one. It's not bending, but it's kind of... See how it's going down like that? The hell? Why didn't I cast? Kind of drifted underneath the bolt. So we're really not getting more bites. We have to turn around and go back to the buoys here. Yeah. Alright. Get this out. It got off. God dang it. Assuming non-markers. It was going good when I first got on here and then just quit. That'd be another Asian smelt. Nope, bull perch. Perch after perch, what is going on here? This one ain't getting bites. Maybe outside the hole. Yep. Ooh. I could throw my UL on. Do this. Nah, I think I will. I'll put it on my center one here. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. Fine. I see I use a medium 6 hook. This is 2.6, so I'll just go put that on easily. We were using this one in here. One fish on. Well, that bugger cast. So I'm thinking that if I can get these broad whitefish on here, easily make get one of these UL records. Well, if you guys need perch live bait, this would be the place for it. Got a little fish on that one. This one. I'm gonna drift too far to the shore over here. Nice peeling. What am I using for a liter? 11.2. That should be. I see the fish on there, but I'm not gonna grab it yet. Might get fish on that one too. Why got 63 fish already? We got a good nice fish on that one. Hope a fish grabs is a whip, but I don't know. Just think about it, it wouldn't matter if we're next to the shore because a lot of people just use the match rig and get these fish. For all we know, it might be where all the dang fish are biting at is the shoreline. Fish biting that. No fish on that one yet. are about to hit the shore edge here, so I definitely need to move. So let's get in position where we'll find the cat first. Something got that one. Don't we need to cast that far at this? The bite rate's insane. It's sad that I got a bunch of non-markered, but you know, maybe I might be able to beat my record. Well, that's nighttime, will kill the bite rate. I don't know. We're gonna move up a little bit. We ain't gonna catch anything. We're basically in the middle of nowhere now. That was a bad cast. I don't know why I cast so short. I'm gonna keep those the way they are. I'm gonna change this to, I think drop shot rig. Gram. Get the lines real quick. Again, drop shot might not be the right one. Maybe I should just use, I don't know what I should be using. Maybe just jigs. Jigging rig. I don't know if I can use this. Texas rig, maybe? This might be a possible. Green. Yeah, hold on. The moment's done. No, let's not do that. Why are you so heavy? One to five, that's 3.5, so let's go ahead and move that down to 1.7. I bet the Omars are all on the shapers. Not completely. Oh, please be a catfish, because there ain't nobody up there with records. And it's a bourbon. Just need to change that color. Maybe this color right here. I only have fish on that one. I didn't bet this at all. I think it's too light, so it's not reaching the bottom. Carolina rig. What's this do? Maybe if I use a smaller hook, maybe it would work. These hooks here, though, are kind of heavy, though. 1 gram, and these are 0.8. It's still too heavy. So maximum. Zero point eight, and that is 3.5. I guess this has some weight to it too somehow. That's about 4 something, and that's 2. That's yeah, okay. That's about 8 grams altogether. All right, let's go back to the wacky rig then. Well, that's it for the fishing. Actually, it was pretty good. I mean, I caught a lot of non-markers. I'll admit that. But you get a lot of fish with this wacky rig. I mean, a lot. I mean, look at 90 fish, guys. I probably caught a lot more if it's just drifted instead of just kept driving back. But got a lot of good fish here, though. Look at that, we actually got a caffeine order for dang perch of all things. 33. Didn't we get anything else? Okay. So all together, 55 minutes. Let's go get rid of the non-markers. Get that out of the way. 57 non-markers, but look at that. Almost 5 silver. Yeah, keep you guys' fish if you guys want to make 5 extra silver out of this. Let's see how much we made from the markers here. 147. So that's not too bad, guys. All right, that will be it for the video. Like the video, guys. Hit that like button. Appreciate it. I thank you guys for watching. Bye, guys.